Hi, this is PDF Bergzerg Arcade at bergzergarcade.com, and this is tutorial 120. Now we're just going to continue on with the functionality of our chess that we've made. So I'm going to open up Unity, and I'm going to open up Model Develop. So let me get these to the right size. I was in full screen mode earlier. All right, so we left off. We could close the chess by closing the loot window here. But what I actually want to do now is when the player moves away from the chest or exceeds its max distance, I also want it to close, and I also want to close this loot window. So that's what we're going to work on next. So we'll just stop it. We'll head over to Mono Develop. Let me open Mono Develop. And if we scroll down to the bottom, we already have a function that will clear out the list of items that we have listed in our window, and we're also calling the mouse up method on our chest, which will, since it's open, will automatically set it to close. So there's probably really not a whole lot we're going to have to do here. So let's head straight into the chest script. Now what we're going to want to do is check to see if it's open, and if it is open and the player moves away, we're going to want to close it. So here's our open. We have no flags set as far as, you know, is it in use or not. So let's go up to the top here. And I'm going to create a private variable up here. It'll be a game object. And I'm just going to call this player. Now every time we open the chest, the very first thing we're going to do is find the player and assign him to this game object we're making. So game object dot find object with tag, and the tag I want to find is player, since that's what my player is tagged as. And on the close, I want to turn around and take that player flag again. And I just want to set it to null. All right. So we're going to go up to our update, which I probably deleted. And it looks like I did. And that looks like a good spot to start. So what I'm going to do is recreate it. And I'm going to check to see if we actually have something stored in our player variable. So if... that's not the way I did it. An underscore player equals null. So if we have nothing stored in our player variable, just return. There's nothing else to do. But if we do have something stored in our player variable, what we're going to want to do is just check the distance. So if vector3 dot distance, and we'll want our transform, and I'm not sure if we're caching that or not. It doesn't look like it. So we might as well do that. So private transform dot, and I'll call it my transform. And in our start method, we'll assign it to equal to transform. A little bit of efficiency, and we're going to want to get our transform.position. Now we've gone through this a few times, so it should be old hat for you. So we're going to grab our player game object. We want its transform and we want its position. And we're just going to want to see if it's greater than max distance. Now, if it is greater than max distance, what we're going to want to do is send another message, and we're going to want to call this close method in the clear window. So let's just send the message. So messenger, we're not going to pass any parameters this time, and we're just going to broadcast. Now we'll need something to broadcast, and I'm going to say close chess. And we're not passing any parameters. And it looks like we forgot one of the parentheses up there. So we'll head over to my GUI. And we'll just scroll up to the on enable and on disable and add listeners for it. So messenger, and we're not receiving any parameters for this one. So add listener. And I forget what I called it already. I believe it was closed chess. Yes, it was. So the listener we'll be adding is closed chess, and the function we want is clear window. I'm just going to copy that, paste it down here, and instead of adding a listener, I'll just simply remove a listener. All right, so let's test that out and see how that works. We have an error. So it's in my chess script, cannot be applied to operand. Let's see what that is. I forgot my little parenthesis there, and we'll get rid of that one. There we go, that should fix that. And it looks like the rest of our errors are gone. So I'll just clear it, we'll start it up. Now I'm sure there's probably gonna be more we have to do. So open it up, it'll populate our little window with 5 items, and we back away. Now we're getting this null reference here. So if we take a look, they all seem to be on the same line. It's all the same null reference. And it's saying that the chess component, chess, so basically it can't find this value. And the reason why is because in update, let's go up to the update. I would check to see if the player equals null, but this message is going to be called over and over again. Because once we move out of that distance, it's going to keep checking. So we could easily fix this by adding one more variable. And I'll make this one public. It's going to be of type bool because it's just going to be basically a toggle. And I'm just going to call it in use. And I'm going to start it off with the default value of false. So I'll copy that variable name. I'm going to come down to, where is it? Open is what I want. And I'll do it right after we try to find the player. And I'm just going to say in use is equal to true. And in my close right after the player, I'm just going to say in use is equal to false. And then the fix, which is in our mouse up. So when we back away and the chest is still open, it's checking our transform, our position. And since now we have this cached, I'm actually going to use that. So quick fix here. Okay, so what it's doing is once we back out, even though we have the chest open, it's checking to see if we're further than max distance. And if it is, we're returning. So we never actually get to call the close state. So what we're going to do is just add a parameter here. And we're just going to say if it's not in use. So check for the distance. If it's greater than max distance and it's not currently being used, allow the basically the mouse up function to keep going through to either open or close the chess. So let's go back in. We'll try that again. Start it up and it should clear on play. We'll just get rid of those warnings. I'll run up. It opens. It's going to generate my items. I'll back up. And ta-da. And we should still be able to close it the regular way. Or the way we did last time. And that works. Now the next thing I want to do is be able to click it to close. And when I close the chest by clicking on it, I want this to disappear too. It looks like we're actually coming up on 10 minutes again. So I'll call this one done and we'll work on the next part in the next tutorial. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.